tell us a bit about the sustainable house and how it grew from the idea of the Dusty Report into a real changing career.
So all I've done is do in the city what farmers do in the country every day. So all the water's from the roof. No stormwater's left there in 16 years. All the sewage is recycled to flush the toilet and wash the clothes. Like a small man.
Nice bouquet.
Thank you very much. And all the energy is from the sun. Four people live there for less than $300 a year for energy and water bills. But I'm so over this, I have to be really clear. I am not a real man. You would not want me in your house. I can barely drive an hour. I'm not special. It's all me-proof, idiot-proof, mods-proof. You can walk out of this room, have this stuff in your unit or your house or your office anywhere in Australia tomorrow. All that you need to do is find this thing in here called your heart and your passion and your love for rainwater and energy in this planet. And as soon as you hear somebody say, an architect, an engineer, a planner, a council officer, you can't do that, you know you're on the right track.
Okay, so we're getting into the nerve centre now. I feel we're moving into that zone where I want to be. So you went down this road and you started to come across these challenges, and then you've just summed it all up by saying it's about the heart. Now, I want to go in a bit deeper.
Oh, gosh, I didn't buy into this. Let's have a go.
What pushed that reality? I mean, I know you were up against it. You were driving change. You were at the front line, and you kept going. But what brought you to sort of come to these conclusions?
I got to where I am the hard way. It variously irritated, infuriated, depressed, got me down, put me off whenever I saw people who wanted to be small. You must read Gulliver's Travels, and you must read about those small people who wanted to tone him down. He writes about it so well, with such restrained humour. So this is what I think works when you're confronted by people who say no to doing things that are good. You do not get angry. You don't get sad. You don't run up a Scotch bill like I do. What you do is you give them solutions. Do not be romantic. So if you're going to a council to do a sustainable project, give them conditions of approval. And I'll give you an example. Imagine this, 1996, there was no concept of a sustainable house in the middle of the city. And I think this is where my legal training paid off. So I didn't go to the council, I went to the New South Wales Health. And I did, in this case, what I did for the Arminimus Health. No is not an option. You can't get no for a project that's $1 billion. You know what your approval conditions are, because you give them to the government, so you give me an approval of those conditions. So I went to New South Wales Health, and I said, I want to recycle the sewage and drink rainwater in the heart of the city. You've got this rule that says you've got to have 150 square metres of absorption area for an on-site sewage system. The whole of my estate in Chippendale on my 5-metre-wide
estate. Site, I like that. Yeah, the estate. Yeah.
Short
compound.
Short mineralized.
Mob's compound.
Exaggerating. The whole of my little terrace is 150 square metres. My back garden is about 20 square metres. And I said, what is the purpose, the public health purpose of that goal? It doesn't tell me how clean the water's got to be. And I'd gone in at a senior level, and his eyes fell to the floor, because it has no public health goal, having 150 square metres of absorption area. It's just something, a figure that blokes, plumbers, and people talking to them, they've drawn up to put in the guidelines.
Yeah, 150 square metre, mate, that'll be fine. That's about how much, yeah. Beauty. That's it. Yeah, that's a guideline, mate. That's a policy.
I've heard that before. Rather than irritate the public servant by saying it's a silly rule, I said, what about if you approve my system and require me to have water that on no count exceeds zero fecal coliforms? Bang. Immeasurable health benefit. He said, of course. At this stage, this younger person who's advised himself to get agitated. And I said, well, that's good. So here's a letter I'd like you to write to me that says that. And the young person couldn't help herself. She reached forward and took it before her superior could get it. And she said, well, we couldn't say that. And I said, well, yeah, that's it could be a problem. How would we say it? She said, well, we could say that. Once you choose your territory to fight on, your home. So I walked out of there with my letter of approval, because I hadn't been romantic. I hadn't gone in there to sort of sacrifice myself on the slope of sustainability. I'd gone in there expecting no, and I'd worked out how to do that. You've got to be smart to save the planet. The people who don't want to do it, and they're in government, we've got to give them ways that are going to work for them. Does that work?
Yes.
Does that story...
Did you say that you being able to achieve that result was down to the fact that you had a legal background, you had an educational background, so that you could go into an environment with the local government and make those arguments and do it on an educated sort of approach? Because a lot of people won't have that. They'll have the desire to do the things you've done, but not the background in which they could approach things in the same way.
That is such a good question. The answer is absolutely yes.
I hear what you're saying there. There's a level now, though, where there's a certain level of understanding and desire.
As of today, I've had over 16,000 people through the house. It's been on CNN 3 times. It's been on the BBC a couple of times, maybe 60 minutes twice. Garden Australia 2 or 3 times. I'm just swept away by what a kitchen and bathroom renovation means to people. And so I worked out something to my dismay. Yes, my house is sustainable in the sense that it keeps 100,000 litres of water on site. But, so he's sucking in his tummy, my tummy needs over 100,000 litres of water in 10 days of eating the food that I eat. My house is sustainable, it gets the water it needs for cooking, showers, baths, etc. But the water in my food is, and the energy, is 30 to 40 times more than
the water. So you've gone from water, then to water in food. And so now that's opened up another new chapter. How did you proceed down the food road, given that it started with water?
Back to my estate. I couldn't grow enough food for myself in my backyard, so I went to the street without approval. And I planted fruit trees out.
Rebel. Rebel.
Without. And so I planted fruit trees, and so my neighbours said we'd like to plant some fruit trees too. And then the council. And I and our community had a fair day, and we planted over 200 fruit trees. So in that day, we changed forever. And people having planted it, what I'm finding is the social glue that comes from gardening is far more exciting than the social glue that comes from making my house sustainable with the water, fish and shower, heavy solar panel. Why? Because it's in that great public living room, the street. We have beautiful streets.
So
we've got about 1,000 fruit trees, herbs and plants. We have bins in the street where people can compost. So we're handling about 30 or 40 tons of food waste and making about 6 to maybe 12 tons of soil a year. And I just want to talk about the magic that lies at our fingertips. You don't want a leaky tap. You don't want a leaky water bottle in your bed or in your bag. But you do want a leaky drain. A leaky drain is intended to keep the water that falls in our cities in the road verge for less than $300. We are keeping over 4 million litres of water where it falls in Chippendale. We're about to go on to the next stage. For less than $4,000, we are going to keep over 52 million litres of water where it falls in Chippendale without approval. We dig up the verge, expose the pipe where it covers, comes across the verge, saw through the pipe, and replace it with a leaky drain or an agricultural drain that's slotted to leak. It has geofabric around it to exclude the soil. 24% of Chippendale and about 30% of our cities are roads. By keeping the water in the road that falls from the roofs and the adjoining properties where it falls, we get 60 to 80% of the water that falls. Most rain falls gently. And so now, instead of that water being washed away to go to the ocean and wasted, we keep it there. There are images showing that the roads of the Sydney City Council, Randwick, Paddington, Chippendale, during the midnight hours of 1 a.m. and 5 a.m. on the 6th of February, are all over 33 degrees, whilst the private land is less than 29 degrees. In other words, roads are red-hot radiators, heating up our cities by 6 to 8 degrees night and day, and increasing the use of aircon by 20 to 50%. Killing ants, which can no longer live in the soil because it's too hot, killing young birds, the time is going to be clear. We need to do this now, because we can cool our cities by several degrees by growing bigger trees with bigger canopies, by leaky drains, and by using the water that falls there.